Let's take a look at the basics of the sampler. The sampler is both a live sampler and a soundboard, which means that you can record something in real time, just like this, and play it back whenever you want to, or you can actually grab something from the internet and put it on one of the buttons. One of the cool technologies that we have in here is a sound leveling algorithm, which means that if you grab samples from all over the place, some are loud and some are quiet, we actually process them as they come in and make sure that to your ear they sound the same level, making sure that you don't have any big surprises in terms of volume levels while you're recording. Let's get to the actual buttons. You've got three banks, A, B, and C, and each one of them can carry four samples. Now obviously I recorded a sample already and you heard me do it, and you can actually see the little waveform that shows up right down here. That is the sample that I just made. Now I just held down the button, and while I was holding it, I said something. While I was holding it, I said something. While I was holding it, I said something. And you can see that the sample's right there. Basically, here you've got your banks A, B, and C, and then an indication of which button it is. So the top left was my first sample, top right is the second one that I made, and then you've got bottom left and bottom right, which are currently empty. Now I can tell that there's something on these sample buttons because they're actually lit up with red. It's a dim red, and it will go brighter when I play it back. While I was holding it, I said something. Then I know it's playing, and you can play more than one at a time. Now after you've recorded a sample, which coincidentally can actually be sampled through your vocal effects, so basically however you hear your voice in the headphones at the time that you're recording it is going to be what gets recorded in the sampler, which makes for some really fun opportunities. Once it's recorded, you can see I have this waveform here. I also have these two little handles that slide back and forth, and I can actually do a little bit of editing just on the length of the sample. So when I play this first sample, we know this is top left, and we know this is my sample. I'm gonna play it just like this. So I heard just like this, but there was a little plop at the beginning. Just like this, here it's like a cuckoo. Just like this, it just happened to be a bit that I captured at the beginning. I want it to be super accurate, and I want to be able to say just like this, so I can hammer the button and go just like this. So watch. Just like this, I've moved this in a bit, and I've cut off that little thump. Just like this, just like this. Now that sample is really tight, and I can repeat it like that. So it's a great little quick trimming tool. Now let's talk about how we bring samples in. I've gone onto the line, and I've gotten myself this Peter Griffin sample from Family Guy, and it's right here. I've brought it into my preset library, or into my sample library. So I clicked on this button, and I literally have Peter here. You can create folders, so you might want to have one of, you know, all Rick and Morty samples, or all samples that you made with a friend one day, or whatever it is. They'll all be in here, including every sample you've ever recorded when you were live. Okay, so I've got all these samples historically, and they're date and time stamped, so you'll know where they are, and you can go back and go through these, find the ones you like, rename them, and probably bring them out of this recorded folder and chuck them in some other kind of keeper folder that we'd use for later. But I'm gonna take this Peter one here, okay? It's actually on my list because it's represented in that folder. And I'm gonna go down to this empty sample and just drag it right in. Boop. Now see how it said analyzing track for a second? That was because it was normalizing the volume relative to other samples that I've already recorded. So I'm gonna take these two handles here because I know that that had a bit of empty space. You can see this little flat line is just empty space. I'm gonna bring those in like that, bring them in, and now I'm gonna play that sample, which I know now is on the bottom left.
Well, you forgot to flip them off, but other than that, nice job.
Right, oh, I cut off a little bit of nice job at the end there, so let's see.
Well, you forgot to flip them off, but other than that, nice job.
So there we go, now I have that sample done. Now, if I wanted to just turn this into something like flip them off, I'd try and figure out where flip them off is here.
Flip them off, but other than that, nice job. Flip them off.
Flip them, there we go.
Flip them off, but.
Oh, got a bit of the butt there. There we go.
Flip them off.
There we go. So now I have Peter saying flip them off.
Flip them off, flip them off.
So it's a really good way to be able to just quickly edit the stuff that you're working on and get the samples to do what you want. Other than that, it's basically just go to town, use as many as you want. You can actually load in long files here. So if you wanted to load in, say, some music that you would run in the background of maybe a D&D encounter, so you start your music up with one sample button here, and then you have maybe some like combat effects or like a giant, you know, beast roaring or something like that, you could do that on the other samples while the music is still playing back in the background. Really, really cool.